The proof of concept paddle was a paddle from Cape Point in the Cape Nature Reserve at the end of the southern tip of Africa, up the west coast, completely unsupported, unaided, solo mission, no support boat, carrying everything with me, including tents, food, all the hydration, all my communication devices, all my emergency equipment. There wasn't a chance to stop. There were no options to quit halfway. It was probably the most testing experience I've had in the last 25 years. There were numerous days where I feared for my life. When you paddle past a shark and you don't even really turn around to check if it's gonna bite you or eat you or follow you, you know you got a hell of a lot of the really important stuff going on in your brain if that's the least of your problems. There were days where I got burnt corneas, huge blisters all over my hands. There were days where I thought I was gonna get smashed up against pinnacles of rocks with 5 to 10 meter surf trying to kill me. There were days where I was so physically exhausted that I actually didn't think I could carry on. But there were also highlights as well. There were days when I paddled with sharks, days I paddled with dolphins and penguins and seals, and one amazing experience where I almost got lost in the mist even though my GPS was taking me out in the wrong direction. But it was a low day, I was completely sunburnt, I was dehydrated, I was stuck in the middle of the mist, and I ended up getting surrounded by 23 humpback whales that pretty much swam all around me, breaching around me and swimming with me, trying to direct me back onto the coastline for almost 45 minutes. And probably some of the most enlightening experiences and most amazingly unique experiences that I don't think many people have had the blessing of having happened to them. The proof of concept paddle made me realize a lot about myself, made me realize my true potential, made me realize that you can push yourself way further than most people truly understand and believe. And when you think you've got absolutely nothing left, that's when you realize that you actually have a well of infinite amounts of energy that's still there, the reserve that most people don't even try and tap into. And when you really physically have to, and as long as you truly believe it and you've got the courage to be able to follow it, you can actually exceed any of your wildest expectations. And I must admit, when I started this project 8 days ago, I wasn't really sure whether I'd be able to get to the point at Lambert Bay, 350 Ks in 8 days. It was incredibly testing on every level. I didn't have any of the conditions that were planned and forecasted. I planned for the worst and hoped for the best on every single day. I made a lot of key decisions that were completely life-threatening decisions, and all of them ended up being the right decision at the right time. But there could have been numerous decisions on a day-to-day basis that could have left me perilously close to death or not coming back at all. And it was a true test of everything that I am as a person and as a waterman, all my knowledge and experience in everything that I've done on the ocean in the last 25 years of my life. And if it wasn't for that, I'm pretty sure I would be dead today. But all those kind of experiences, if you utilize them, you realize that none of the mistakes you made in the past are mistakes. They're just life lessons, and you've got to push yourself and test yourself constantly to be able to realize your own potential and live your goals and achieve your dreams. What you call them friends you never see, reminisce some memories, but you forget.